this time around for him. He's got a brand new soft rear in it. Stay with Pol Espargaró for now, then he's just about to click through second to two. Just a fraction of time there, 2/10 down on fastest set by Franco Morbidelli. Nakagami's going to go second, the up 57-4-1-1. He's not dropped out of the top five too often so far today, has he? All going the way of Taka Nakagami. This is where the riders are getting problems getting that rear tyre hooked up. Let's have a quick listen here to Pol Espargaró going up Horsepower Hill. Yeah, you can hear it whining there, can't you? But not a bad lap anyway, because Morbidelli's advantage at the front is so large right now with 4 minutes left. At this time, even if he was to lose a tenth or two in the final sector, should put Pol Espargaró up into second place. And look at that, he's really struggling wrestling that KTM round the final turn. He does indeed go up into second place with the 57.059.
You know there's not a lot of grip around because the KTM, that's what used to do in the past. It doesn't do that now. The 2020 bike, they've found a way to put all that horsepower down the ground electronically and mechanically. You don't really see the KTM being a rodeo ball these days. Just saw there, Pol Espargaró still taking a bit of lean angle coming out that final corner. That rear tyre really started to spin up on him. You see Dranmir there as well, it was loose, not hooking up as he wanted coming out of that turn number 12 up the hill.
Yeah, you're right, and Suzuki's just don't look loose. It's just not something you see. It's a good lap from Dranmir, but look at that front end. Do you know what I can't help but think? Bumpy, no grip. This would have been tailor-made for Marc Márquez. These are conditions where he really does excel.
Struggles with French doors. Well, yeah, he has struggles with French rivals at the moment as well, doesn't he? I mean, nothing's really gone his way French-wise so far in 2020.
Yeah, watch out, everyone.
Yes, yeah, stand back.
So it's just 2.5 minutes left of this session. Elation Espargaró with a good time. He's just gone up into sixth, 57.041. Everyone now looking to try and get a time to bag them a place in Q2.
Good first sector from Maverick Viñales. Can't believe I'm saying this about a rider of this calibre. Going for podiums in MotoGP for the first time in 3 races in a row. Astonishing.
Yeah, it's a statistic that you think you'd be rolling out more often.
100%. Let's have a look at the Maverick in the infield section. Excellent first sector he had. He's about to come through sector two.
Chapman has just pinched a place inside the top ten. He's up into ninth place. That puts Rossi in tenth for now. So Rins, Quartararo, Dovi and Binder have been nudged out of that crucial top ten for now.
Was that Quartararo? It is Quartararo behind Viñales. Yeah, there's Fabio Quartararo at the top of your picture. So if he wants a reference ahead of him, not that he normally needs it when it comes to time attack modes, Fabio Quartararo. Maverick Viñales is perfectly positioned as far as Fabio's concerned, just to use him as a bit of a reference ahead.
So this is his outlap, remember, Quartararo, so he's only going to have one flying lap at it.
Usually on a soft tyre, that's all that he needs, isn't it? I mean, he really has become the qualifying king in MotoGP.
He needs a lap as well
on the trot now, isn't it?
He needs a lap.
Yeah, he's not in that top 10 right now.
Brad Binder's just put Rossi out as well. He's moved up into 10th place. What about Valentino at the moment? He'll get one more lap at it, will here comes Mir, he stays fifth, he's probably safe for now. No one can even get close to Franco Morbidelli's 56.5.
Viñales should be over the line now, yeah, there he is. 56.997, so nothing going for Viñales in terms of Morbidelli's pace.
Oliveira's lap was mighty, mighty close, wasn't it? Morbidelli, Oliveira and Zarco, I didn't even see Oliveira and Zarco's times. 56.550.
Well, Miguel Oliveira, what has he found on a soft tyre? Nowhere last year, did not even see a Q2 session in 2019, yet here he is now, fifth on the grid he was in Jerez after a brilliant performance to get into Q2 for the first time, and he's looking strong yet again with Miguel Oliveira in soft tyre time attack mode. Brilliant to see. Oh, surprise, surprise, Fabio Quartararo estimated P1.
Suzuki's not too shabby through here. It's that final sector that will be key. His teammate at the moment still fastest, 56.5. Checkered flag has just come out here in Renault at the end of free practice two.
Yeah, you know that the Yamahas and the Suzukis, they rely so heavily, certainly with this new Michelin rear tyre on edge grip, as Simon Crafar mentioned earlier on, edge grip lacking a lot of here so far. So will that just negate the advantage that the Yamahas and the Suzukis have? They'll be working on their setup to try and get that little bit extra edge grip overnight, of course. And it will be better tomorrow with more rubber laid down.
Fabio Quartararo then.
Sarko as well, look at him, he's on a fly as well. It's France versus France at the moment at the end of this session.
Well, he always used to love a time attack, didn't he, Joan Zarco himself? That would be something, wouldn't it? Binder's just crossed the line and proved his time 10th. Thomas Bargro 7th. Checkered flag, he's out, remember. Quartararo here is so, so close. He's going to book a place, surely. But this is mistake 3 through the last couple of turns. This could be a 1-2 for the Petronas Yamaha SRT team.
Here he comes then. Out of the final corner, Fabio Quartararo runs on the curve, checker flag is out, he got his tops. How often have we seen that when Fabio Quartararo clicks into time attack mode? He can be unbeatable. It's a shake of the head, 56.50, he doesn't exactly look over enamored with the situation, but he is quickest. It is a Petronas Yamaha SRT 1-2. What about Miguel Oliveira? Looks like he's going to end this session in a brilliant third place, 56.550. The best from the Portuguese man.
Yeah, I mean, both he and Joan Zarco can be very, very proud of their efforts here in this session. Joan Zarco across the line there, of course, third on the grid here last year. What a job that is.
Well, let's be honest, Zarco is trying to put himself in the shop window here for a better Ducati ride next year. You know, he's kind of looking at the Dovizioso situation, thinking if Dovi doesn't get the deal done with Ducati, Beckenbach now gets moved up to the factory team. He's got big ambitions and big hopes of convincing Ducati to lump him on one of those Pramac Jeeps next year.